Arthur! Arthur!
What now? You sweating yet, Dutch?
Of course I'm sweating. We're in some disease-ridden, swampy, Dixie-whistling shithole.
I meant about what Trelawney said about these bounty hunters.
Well, not sweating as such, but maybe a little gentle perspiration. Until we know more, ain't too much harm in wasting good liquor on sweating.
So?
So, I think you should pay Mr. Trelawney a visit and find out exactly what he knows and who he spoke to. Take Charles with you. Oh, the sight of the pair of you would make a statue sing out its secrets.
Okay.
All right, man. Let me tell Charles.
Charles, I need you for some business in town. Come on.
Okay.
Pardon me.
Easy, girl. Where are we going? Dutch wants us to have a talk with Trelawney about these bounty hunters who are coming for us. Hoping he can tell us who they are or where they're coming from.
Okay. And you're deputies now.
Something like that.
Hey, wait up!
My horse is too fast, I can't handle it.
Sheriff who runs that town. I knew Dutch was gonna play him like a fiddle.
On the run from one bunch of lawmen, working for another. Interesting.
Hiding in plain sight, Dutch calls it.
So, spirits seem good. In the new camp, I mean.
We got some space between us and that mess now.
Whoa, whoa!
Someone got here first.
Oops.
So it seems.
By the looks of things, it wasn't a social call.
Doesn't look like
it's the house.
Gone.
Search things.
This food's barely touched. Looks like he left in a hurry.
You see anything there? What do you think?
Bed's not made, so he must have been here recently.
Big struggle. Pretty recently, I'd say.
Look,
I guess maybe 12 hours ago.
Come on. But no body?
Not yet. They went down the path here. How's your tracking these days?
All right, I guess.
Well, lead the way then.
Go easy, girl.
place I'd expect.
Trelawney staying in.
No?
Normally scams himself into the best hotel in.
You know, when me and Javier went down with Trelawney to get Sean after the bar fight, I swear he talked the whole way and never actually said a damn thing.
I thought you knew. That's his special talent. They could be 20 miles away by now.
We can track them that far if we need to. Depends on how much you want to find them.
Yeah. I still ain't sure about that.
Hey, look. They continue on the other side of the tracks. These tracks lead into the forest here.
Careful! Hey, look. Let's go see what those fellas have to say. Whoa!
Stop walking into me.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
Have you seen him? We're looking for our friend.
I don't think he's here.
You seen a strange sort of feller? Sort of formal?
Strange? Sure. Formal? Nah.
He uses a cane. Looks a lot like this one.
All right, you two.
Where the hell is he?
You both better get out of here.
Come here.
You are.
You want to come at me?
You stay there.
It's Trelawney.
I don't know anything.
Well, I got to punch him in the face.
Tell me where he is.
You go to hell.
You better tell me now, you son of a bitch.
Okay. Okay, for Christ's sake. They took him to a cabin over by the cornfields.
Which cornfields?
Left. Down the path there by Braithwaite Manor.
Let me see you again. You hear me?
You got lucky there, my friend.
Come on, let's go.
Follow me. I think there's a way around so we don't have to go through the Braithwaite place.
Yes. I've spent enough time there. After you, then. Yeah!
You okay?
I'm good.
What do you think they want with Trelawney?
Could be any one of 100 things. Just depends if any of them involve us.
You think he'll talk?
Of course he'll talk. He'd sell his own sister to save a train fare. He don't know how not to talk. He don't know where we're holed up, though. At least I don't think he does.
I don't know why Dutch still deals with him. Always disappearing for weeks on end.
He's got his uses.
I don't trust him.
Loyalty matters to Dutch.
Of course. But is Trelawney loyal?
Yeah, kind of. I guess Trelawney ain't exactly disloyal. Just got a big mouth. Don't worry. If he talked, I'll goddamn find out what he said. Nothing's ever straightforward where Trelawney's involved. Learn that much.
I mean, how much time have we wasted getting this fool out of trouble?
He somehow manages to be both lucky and unlucky at the same time.
That's one way of looking at it.
But he always finds some way to pay us back. Just when we think about cutting him loose, he brings us something big. I guess that's his special talent. Keeping fish on the line.
Okay, girl. That must be it.
Easy.
Let's get you out of here. Come on, boy.
The thing is, after that shack, this will be remembered like a good time.
Put the man down, gentlemen. Is that the lot of them?
I think so.
So you're alive.
Allegedly.
Well, don't worry, they won't be for much longer.
Look, go get them, Arthur. I can handle this.
Don't deal with them, my brothers.
Who knows what... Told them, let's get after those sons of bitches.
They've gone into the cornfields. We need to flush them out.
Might as well loot him.
I'm telling you now, you boys ain't leaving here.
I think there's one over here. They're gonna get away. Let's find them.
One more, Charles.
Look at the birds. Go that way.
Where the hell is he?
Hey! I see something on the ground over here!
He's dumped his gear. Look around. He can't have gone far.
Take him and get out of here.
You have my friend.
He's not your friend. I'll give you money.
Be quiet.
Yikes.
Come on.
You should have taken the money.
I know. I'm a fool.
Yeah.
Should be the last of them.
All right, let's go back for Trelawney. You all right?
Yeah. Never goes easy, does it?
Sure don't. Come on. Let's go see how badly they beat up the slippery fella. I wonder how much trouble he's brought with him.
Guess we'll soon find out.
Seems like we can't catch a break now, Arthur.
Our luck's held this long. We got out of worse scrapes than this one.
So I heard.
Sure. What's government agents and bounty hunters to us?
I hope you're right.
Whoops. My stamina is mad high now. Like, I could run for days. Watch this, you ready? Like a marathon.
Mr. Trelawney, where are you?
Over here, dear boy.
I don't like this guy.
Well, he's still here, at least. Put your feet up, why don't you?
You okay?
Never finer.
So, who was they?
They were bounty hunters. Attached to Cole Stoudemire.
Okay.
Weren't looking for me, per se.
What you tell them?
Not much. I told them I was an intellectual. Come down here from Oregon, looking for a job at the university. Of course, they didn't believe me. Seems you stirred up quite a hornet's nest in Blackwater.
So I keep hearing.
It might be best if I stay with you, gentlemen, for a while. Can't go back to that caravan now.
All right, Charles. You take Trelawney back to camp. I'll catch up with you.
Okay.
Horse flesh.
Can I
for
help
dinner.
You?
Well, looks like you boys had some trouble.
Yeah, we had some trouble. Bad trouble. What you want?
Oh, I was supposed to meet some business partners here. They arranged a meeting, I believe.
Fellow with a scar and a Mexican?
Yes, sir.
Out by the stables, I think.
Thank you. And, sorry for your troubles, friend.
We're good men, like you.
You don't know me. You turn up and down, you're helping everybody. And there's trouble everywhere. Bandits attack my fields. Men getting killed. Just who are you?
And have you met my partner, Arthur Morgan?
No.
I met your son, the sheriff.
Okay.
Mr. Gray here was saying how he had problems with a family.
Look at that beard.
A family of degenerates.
Oh, well, nobody likes degenerates.
Hag and her inbred sons. They ruined this county. They killed my uncle, you know.
That ain't right.
Problem is, we can't be seen to get too close.
And?
We've got gold, Yankee. We've got gold.
I ain't no Yankee, friend. I ain't nothing. My daddy came over on the boat from Scotland.
I'm Scottish.
And the Braithwaites?
Goddamn peasants. I don't know. Mongrels. Slave fuckers. All you gotta do is look at them.
How much gold?
Enough. These are prized horses I'm talking about. Them, they'll get you 5,000.
5,000? For horses?
Easy.
Where do we sell them, these $5,000 horses?
Over in Clemens Cove. Fellow over there will run them out of state and give you 50 cents on the dollar.
Mister, you got yourself a deal.
Just keep us away from this. Publicly, I mean.
My sense is we keep all horse wrestling away from the public.
What's up, Dark? How's it going, dude?
Go to the
stables. All right, time to get some horses.
South side of the manor. That's where they keep the thoroughbred.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Time to steal some horses.
Coming past.
Okay.
If he only knew we just torched his tobacco crop.
That was you?
The old man was cursing the Braithwaites about that.
Burning rich folks' property? Sean was like a pig in shit.
I'm sure. 5,000 for horses. They must be rich.
Yeah, he doesn't know what he's talking about. But if we get even a third of that, it'll be worth it.
So how are we gonna play this?
The place is well guarded, so there ain't no point in blasting in there. We'll make them think we're there looking to purchase.
Three armed men?
You'd be armed if you were about to spend 5,000 on horses. We should go in the back way.
He's got a point.
Boy, too many questions. Careful. There's a guard.
I'll speak to him, okay?
All right, then.
Can I help you, gentlemen?
Yeah, we're here to see about some horses.
Horses?
Yeah, we had an appointment with Mr. Braithwaite, I believe.
Yeah, I never heard about any of this.
Our partner wanted to make a significant investment in some stables down here. But perhaps we should look elsewhere.
Well, okay then. Head on up to the stables. Someone will come see you.
Thank you, sir. Looking at stables.
Yeah.
All right. I think that's the stables just up ahead. Heads down. Play cool. Head around the front. Hitch up there. All right. Let's hitch up here.
Eso.
Let me do the talking.
Help you boys?
I hope so. Heard you got some horses.
We always got horses.
Fine horses, I mean.
I don't get you, friend.
Yeah, you do. Come on.
Listen, why don't you get out of here? You, Scarface, and your greaser buddy.
Whoa!
I don't like officials.
We ain't officials. We're connoisseurs looking to do some breedings. Come on now,
breedings.
Partner.
Okay, fine. Follow me. These here's mainly the studs available for purchase or for working. That's what you're interested in. What is your boys interested in?
We represent a famous stable and stud farm from Saratoga.
Is that so?
Unofficially.
Of course. Well, this here's Cerberus. Here you go, boy. Cerberus is a real reliable.
I'm sorry.
Greaser, huh?
Okay. Bandana's on. Don't need nobody recognize.
You know what that means, chat? Bandana's on. So the bandana is on. We don't need nobody recognizing us. There we go. There we go.
Peasants.
All right, I'll grab the white one in the middle. You get the other two. Relax, boy. Come on.
Good boy.
Hey, easy now.
Easy. It's okay.
Marston, you're going to tether him up to Javier's horse.
Okay.
Javier? You're gonna lead the stallions.
Yeah.
Marston, you ride point. I'll cover up the back. If there's any problems, we regroup at Clemens Cove.
Okay. What are you doing?
Let's go, quick!
Oh, crap! Well, looks like we're going after it now.
These men, stop! I'm gonna piss on your car! Look out ahead! They're coming out of the fields! No! But do not hit the horse!
Watch it! They're guarded by that wagon!
My shot is nice with this now. Cool.
Whoa, you okay there, boy?
Well, that one horse is not happy.
Shit! One of the stallions is loose. Keep going. I'll get him.
Oh, whoa, 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 that's not what I wanted. Right up here. Come on.
Hey, Morgan! Over here! You got him. Well done. Clemens Cove's just over there. Come on. Let's get this over with.
Well, that could have gone smoother.
That'll be on my gravestone. Come here! You think they look like they're paying $5,000 for horses?
We'll see.
Come here.
What you boys want?
Heard you was, heard you pay good prices for horses.
Oh, we'll buy more or less anything, Pop.
That so?
Sure, Pop. I'm Clay Davies. That's my brother Clive. We're twins.
John, Arthur,
Clay
Javier.
So what are you? Cuban?
No.
I don't like Cubans.
That so?
Maybe. Why, what do you care? You ain't Cuban.
Maybe I like Cubans.
Ooh, you're funny. He's funny. Ain't he funny, Clive? Clive don't talk.
We're twins, but I was born first. He came out all yellow and black, but he's okay.
Sure.
Yeah, I know these horses. They ain't yours, but I like you, and I'll give you... I can give you 650 for
them. I was told we could get up to $5,000 for them.
And I was told the moon was made of ladies' tears. Only it ain't true. Not one little bit.
But...
I like you boys, but I ain't got more than 700 on me. You want it, or you want to ride them fellers into town, and maybe someone there will hang.
Yikes.
You.
We're gonna need more than that.
I ain't got no more money, Pop. Here, take it or leave it. Uh-huh.
All right.
You goddamn fool, Marston.
Ain't no one around here got $5,000, boys, but nice meeting you. See you boys again, I hope. Come on. Yeah. Close the gate, Clive.
We only got a couple hundred for those horses.